Name's Jess.
She's got a knack for trouble.
Check in on her for me, would you?
Thanks for busting me out. Name's Jess. If you're out here picking fights with the cult, then I'm guessing you already know my Uncle Dutch. Look, I don't got a lot of time to waste. I'm gonna get right to the point. I was on the trail of one of Jacob's zealots. Goes by the name The Cook. Yeah, don't sound so scary. But believe me, he's one twisted fuck. Almost tracked him down, but a Peggy patrol got the drop on me. I need your help. We can't let this trail go cold. If you're looking to hook up with the Whitetails, this could be your way in. And more importantly, you'd help put an evil motherfucker in the grave. Gotta move. Wasted too much time already. Follow me. This way.
Never expected you'd be so handy in a fight. Thanks.
See that? That's his calling card. Innocent people. burned alive. Goddamn cults grabbing everything. They'll take you from your home, the bar, even church. Then they slot you into one of two categories, weak or strong. See, Jacob's building an army, and anyone who can't or won't fight for it winds up dead. Culling the herd, he calls it. Wholesale slaughter innocent people. Nobody believed it was happening, because nobody wanted to believe.
Thank you.
to the cook. Yeah, the parents on posts decided to give the kids a little water. And then he asked if they were hungry. The kids were starving, so they said yes. Started begging for food. Cook asked if they want pork. Kids said yes. So he went out to the parents and took their shoes off and started to play. This little piggy went to market, and the blood poured like a damn faucet. Cook had a big old grin on his face as he offered each little piece to the kids. I'd feel better. I feel numb. Dutch was right. Cook's dead and I don't feel anything. All I ever wanted was to find this guy. And now I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Dutch has been right about a lot of shit lately. The cult, Eli, maybe he's right about you too. You need someone to watch your back? Call me. And, thanks for everything you've done.
Hey, Deputy. That niece of mine. She don't make friends easy. But if you want things done quickly and quietly, she's your girl. Keep her safe for me, okay? She's been through a lot.
Thanks for saving my hide. Hell, everyone's heard of Clutch Nixon. He's a fucking legend around here. We're all rooting for you.
Drubbin's place is a fucking fort. If I needed some help, that's where I would go. You should head over there, see if they need...
Thanks fucking Christ for the First Amendment.
Drubbin's place is a fucking fort. If I needed some help, that's where I would go. You should head over there, see if they need any help.
So tough. How come this place is swarming with cultists?
you can run. Hunters, don't sound too good. If Jacob wants you, he's gonna send his best out after you. Watch your back, deputy.
I'm just glad to see it out of the cult's hands, training those wolves to cause hell. And they've been...
What the hell?
Oh, man, the heavy!
Roger, get left!
Shipping those crazy wolves all the way to the old lumber mill to keep an eye on prisoners. Now, we had a bear here named Cheeseburger. Bit of a local celebrity, actually. Had a soft spot for Chad's barbecue. But he got the diabetes, so we put him on a liquid salmon diet. Anywho.
Used to be gods. And now our heroes are godless, weak, feeble, diseased. We let the weak dictate to the powerful, and then we are shocked to find ourselves adrift. But history knows the value of sacrifice. So that it stays strong. Over and over, the lives of the many have outweighed the lives of the few. This is how we survived, and we've forgotten. And now, the bill has come due. Now, the collapse is upon us. And this time, the lives of the few outweigh the lives of the many. And when a nation that's never known hunger or desperation descends into madness, we'll be ready. We will call the herd. We will do what needs to be done.
Thank you.
Good. Call the herd.
Sully, when did they get him? Why are we even bothering with this? They're all
check him anyways.
Why am I all stuck on corpse duty? Holy shit! Oh,
what?
Fuck.
Live one. Walker, go to the truck.
Yes, sir.
Oh, my God. I'm so sorry. Give me a hand, kid. Eli, is this?
Yep.
What the fuck is the deputy doing here?
Jacob took a shine to him, same as us. You're gonna be okay, hero. Whitetail's got you now.
We're bringing him back to the wolf's den?
Where else?
Tammy's not gonna like this.
Don't worry about Tammy, she'll be fine.
Are you out of your fucking mind?
Now hold on, Weedy and I agree.
Oh, you agree?
Whoa. I was at best an impartial observer.
This is stupid. And this is dangerous. You both know better.
What was I supposed to do?
Leave him to die.
Tammy.
They've been in that room for God knows how long. I've seen what it does to people. You haven't. You can't trust this one.
That's what everyone said about you. But luckily, I didn't listen. This is not up for discussion. We need him. That's all there is to it. Understand?
You're right. She took that real well.
Out!
He didn't do anything.
I meant what I said. We need you. Let's get you some rest.
Hey, bud.
Hey, Dad.
You're looking better now. Good, go see Eli.
I used to love
need you.
Before the pagan.
Hey there, guy.
I always get stuck on shit,
job. Good to see you standing. Been trying to track you down, deputy. Dutch speaks highly. Look, I'll get right to it. I know what you did down south. You got the father thinking twice now, and that's good for us. We're bleeding bodies up here. No two ways about it. I don't know if we'll be able to hold out more than a week at this rate. Times are desperate, to say the least. I'm trying to get some footholds back, so I sent a handful of whitetails out to sabotage the visitor center. The cult's been using it as a depot for that bliss shit. But our guys walked right into a fucking trap. They've been taken hostage, and we're up against the clock. If I just send another group in there, we risk losing everything. But you, you're something that cult ain't expecting. You're the only one I got around here who can handle this, Step. Only one I trust to handle this. I'm counting on you. You'll need to go in quiet. Cult gets wind you're around, they're liable to kill our people. There's a bow on the table if you need it. Get our people back, Depp. Good luck.
Not safe to hunt when Jacob's the boys running around.
All 84. By the way, I got great night vision.
Don't worry about him. Might have come across a little harsh earlier. I ain't apologizing. I'm just acknowledging. I don't trust people I don't know. But Eli says you're all right, so I gotta go with that until I see otherwise. You prove your worth, and you and I will get along just fine. Here's the deal. Weedy's trying to get a pirate radio station up and running. He told Eli it's to help coordinate the militia, but I'm pretty sure he just wants to play his own music. So we're gonna indulge him. Problem is, he can't get a signal out. Our friend here said the cult's been jamming this whole area. Also told us how. Seems there's two radio towers with jammers on them and a third on a mobile unit patrolling the roads. Take the towers out first. That ought to clear the signal enough for me to locate the patrol. I'll let you know when I find it. Do this, and maybe we can start building some of that trust up.
Bet these gated aren't stable and hard to find any ammo. Those cult bastards moved in.
So, you've met Eli. You're in good hands now. He'll get you squared away with anything they need up there in the mountains. I'll still keep an eye on you, though. Talk soon, kid.
They were gonna kill me. Thanks. There were more of us.
Looks like we've got a bit of a problem. Last couple of Bliss convoys didn't make it to their destination.
This is getting lively!
Set up a checkpoint in the tunnel, and let's see how many sinners we can catch. Any that don't talk will.
Oh, you big time.
Save our guy.
We've got two whitetails at Hawkeye Tunnel.
Fuck! Depp, they took two of our people up to Devil's Drop. Jacob's on the warpath trying to find a wolf's den. If the Peggies find us, we don't stand a chance. But if our guys don't give up the location, they'll be tossed off that cliff. All eyes, Depp. Devil's Drop's to the south of you. Helping us take care of our own is gonna have a big impact on morale. Maybe even get some more folks to join up, too. Shit. I knew Tammy was wrong about you. Congratulations. You're one of us now. If you got time, I got more work. Come see me in the wolf's den when you're ready. Outstanding work, Depp. We're gonna take this goddamn mountain back from Jacob. I know it. Picking up a lot of angry chatter from the cult. They're calling in chopper convoys to patrol for whitetails. Keep your head on a swivel and an eye to the sky.
Get vertigo. That'll do it. Next tower's northeast. It's on a cliff overlooking the hotel. If you got a wingsuit, now's the time to use it. Just try not to crash.
forests, vast deserts, and concrete. Miles and miles of concrete scar tissue crisscrossing the natural world. Cities. Modern society. The great vampire sucking the world dry. It is a disease, a cancer, leeching beauty, virility, and life from this planet. We must return to our natural selves, warriors, hunters, animals. Because if we do not, we will cease to exist. The great collapse.
On a truck. South.
It's on the road south of you. You might have time to set up an ambush if you hurry.
Thank you. the weeks leading up to May 10th, 1971, Clutch Nixon.
Job for you. You remember the Grandview Hotel? That shithole we pulled you out of? Need you to head back there. Jacob nabbed a whitetail by the name of Briggs, and he's using the same brain-melting nonsense he tried on you. All in the hopes that Briggs will give up the wolf stand. I don't think our boy can hold out as long as you did. And if he gives up our location, we're done. So we gotta move on this quick. Some folks here think the smart move would be just to off him. But if we start killing our own to save our asses, how's that make us any better than Jacob? Nah, I ain't going down that road. Here's what we're gonna do instead. Wheaties cooked up a little deprogramming package. Same thing we used on you. Need you to swap out the tape they got running in Briggs' room with the one I'm gonna give you. And then, well, then we'll see what happens. If everything goes smooth, our guy comes back to Earth. If it doesn't, well, we'll deal with that when the time comes.
If you think you're ready, you're not.
Wasn't sure you'd come back, but I guess you're full of surprises. This squealer here ran security up at the chalet. Lucky for us, he wasn't that good at his job and wound up in my kiddie pool. Seems the place is being used as a training ground for the Chosen. If you've seen them in action, you know how ruthless they are. You know what Jacob taught them to use for target practice? Live bodies. Gets their first kill jitters out of the way. These motherfuckers don't value any life that ain't in their cult. And they need to be put down like the dogs they are. So you're gonna head up to that chalet. You're gonna kill every Chosen you see, and you're gonna rig that building with explosives. And then we're gonna watch that whole fucking place turn into a smoldering heap of ash. Sound good to you?
Harder to hide.
Hey. Got a sec?
That's the challenge.
Whitetail Militia's been ready for this fight for years. Eli made sure we had caches stashed all over the place. Guns, ammo, you name it. Gotta be prepared for anything, you know? But the way things are going, we need those supplies here. Not sitting in some bunker waiting to be found. Last thing we need are the fucking Peggies stumbling across our shit. So if you could get those supplies, it'd be a big help for us. But, there is one problem. We don't keep a map of the caches here. Don't ask me why. Safeguards, or some bullshit. There's a scout up at the Jefferson Lookout Tower who should have one. Place is just west of here. Good luck, and be careful out there. John Henry, he went
up the mountain. I just gave my first rabbit, and that's fine.
One of you will be strong. Not again.
Get out of your peaches.
I know you are in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh, huh? You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified of becoming a father, mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were gonna work out. She always had faith. Gonna go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take it. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong because my little girl was gonna live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. When all she had in the world was me. When nobody from nowhere with thought me. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head. And I leaned in and I could smell her. And we prayed together. Prayed for wisdom. Prayed for strength. taped to her angelic face and I pinched it shut. After a little while, her legs began to kick and kick. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth and the Lord. Sacrifice. These are all part of his test. And we have to prove that we can serve God, no matter what he asks. You've done well.
Time. understand something, Deb. No one comes back from Jacob's chair the same. I've seen it firsthand. You go in one way, and you come out another. Eli thinks you're clear, but only time will tell. Anyhow, plenty more to do back at the Wolf's Den. Stop by if you're around, and thanks, Deb, for all you've been doing.
you must be hungry. Did you know it takes 10 days for civilization to collapse? Yeah. You take away a man's basic needs and he will revert to his primordial instincts in just 10 days. That's a difficult thing to understand unless you've lived it. You know, I was in Iraq during the first Gulf War. 82nd Airborne All-Americans, hoorah! One night there was an ambush, and me and this guy named Miller got separated from the unit. No food, no radio. Nearest base, 200 clicks to the south, so we just started walking. Well, by the third day I knew we were lost. Day six, ran out of water. You know what that's like, don't you? Difficult to swallow. On the seventh day, Miller's legs started going all wonky. Did you know your brain starts to eat your muscles in order to survive? That's why you're so goddamn skinny. And by the eighth day, the wolves were closing in. And I looked at Miller and I could tell we were as good as dead. And I accepted that. And in that acceptance came clarity. You see, I wasn't just looking at Miller. I was looking at an opportunity. It wasn't something I wanted. It was something that I had to do. It was my test. You see, Miller's sacrifice wasn't about me walking out of that desert. It was about bringing me here. The weak have their purpose. You'll understand that soon enough.
Starts again. Follow me. planned out. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Then he's got you. It becomes second nature routine. He gets in your head. And you don't even realize it. You can't ever go back. Do you understand? You can't ever go back. Come on. Truck's gotta be there. Gotta get on the truck. It's almost done. I've studied the route for weeks. It's the only way out. You'll be safe if you don't.
They're gone!
Find them! That's an order!
Plans
everywhere!
No, not yet! Not yet!
Thank you.
hunger or desperation descends into madness, we will be ready. We will call the weak. We will do what needs to be done. This world is weak.
If you found him, just let the tape do its thing. Ah, shit. I'm seeing trucks headed your way. Jacob must have been waiting for us to hit him again. Kid, I'm seeing mortars and MGs outside. Get creative. They got lots of toys out there.
job, Deb. You're a goddamn hero in my books. Things are looking real good for Briggs. Whitetails are on the way to pick him up. Jacob won't be using the Grandview to fuck with anyone now. Goddamn. I'd love to see his ugly mug when he hears he lost his little torture chamber.
Our legs.
You know, you proved everyone wrong, Deb. Everyone except me. Always knew you were the real deal. I'll see you back at the den, soldier. Take care.
Okay, girl. It's go time.
Thank you.
patrol headed your way. Better hurry.
Glad we can actually put this stuff to use instead of letting it collect dust in some bunker. This is a big help. I can't believe you caught those guys. Thought for sure they'd get away. If we had a couple more people like you around here, Eden's Gate would have rolled over a long time ago. Thanks again, Deputy.
I'm not gonna kill you.
I'll never give this beautiful valley up.
Time will.
I'll be right there.
I don't like turning my back on him.
Probably wasting your time. You're lucky you got me. Beauty deer. My granny took one down with his bare hands. It's child's play.
I'm looking at the target!
Make it move. Get ready. It's Lawrence.
Down below!
Yeah.
I'm just glad to see it out of the cult's hands, training those wolves to cause hell. And they've been shipping those crazy wolves all the way to the old lumber mill to keep an eye on prisoners. Now, we had a bear here named Cheeseburger, bit of a local celebrity, actually. Had a soft spot for Chad's barbecue, but he got the diabetes, so we put him on a liquid salmon diet. Anywho, cult tried to take him, so I set him free. Last I heard, he was causing all sorts of mayhem. Someone should go find him, make sure he's all right. Grab some salmon from the pond ahead of time, though. Then feed Cheeseburger that salmon, and he'll be eating out of the palm of your hand.
One less place to train their fucking judges. Keep your eyes on the road. I'll do the rest.
Gotta move!
arrow right through the eye, dead before they even hit the ground. Sometimes I want to make sense. Here's where you get the most bang. Hey! Let me know if you find anything. They keep trying. Awesome tracking down a Peggy hunting party, taking them out one by one. Gives me a serious.
Little guy, lead a rat out of your hand, don't you worry.
As long as he's with you, I know he's safe. Just remember, don't actually feed him cheeseburgers. Because, you know, he's got the diabetes.
I got my own shit.
Deputy, I heard you saved old Cheeseburger from the cult. Good work. Fowler.
Hey, Migos, it's me. Hey, Migos, it's me, Herc. Just hold up my old man.
Has trained him well. I'd barrel him all anything you tell him to. And he's something of a local celebrity. So don't be surprised if people care more about him.
Some bitch Dutch was going on about. You a registered voter? Ah, don't matter. I need help of a different sort. Let's get to the point. You see that steaming pile of disappointment over there praying? That's my loin fruit, Hurt Jr. Dumber than a coal bucket. He takes after his mama. Stupid some bitch went and lost my campaign truck, Nancy. So named after the greatest first lady to ever serve this fine country, of course. If them Obama-loving libtards find out I can't look after my own property, I can kiss this Senate run goodbye. Now, seeing as you're on my land, and I didn't kill you, even though it's well within my rights as a red-blooded American gun owner, I say you owe me. Help numbnuts get my truck back, so I can start focusing on my campaign again. Junior, someone's here to help you. Try.
Hey, down there!
I can't do this by myself.
That Eli, he's a sneaky sumbitch, I'll give him that.
they get here soon, because I can't feel my knees anymore.
Hey, man, I'm sorry. I don't want to go on assuming nobody's gender or nothing. I mean, I don't mean no disrespect. I just call all my homies dude or bro or man, you know, regardless of vagitalia or penile-ness.
Whoa, deja voodoo, man. Have we met before? Dang, man, my prayers have been answered. I got a direct line to that sweet little monkey god whose heart hangs in heaven. Well, I guess since you're an angel working here on Earth, the Monkey King, that you already know I got to get my daddy's truck back. I mean, he's real butt sore. But if we get it back, he'll let me sleep in my bed again. And I gotta tell you, man, it's getting real cold outside. Never mind them wood ticks crawling all up in my junk, threatening me with Lyme disease and whatnot. So come on, man, help me get my daddy's truck back. Let's make dust before the old man starts shooting. He's hotter than a ghost pepper these days. Santa Run's been real stressful on him, man. He ain't cut out for that shit. You know how busy he is? Doesn't even have time to cut out for a shit. Shit, man, I've been praying on this all day, man. I've been asking the Monkey King, all the baby Jesuses, even the little Valentine's one, just to send me a sign, man, and they sent me you. I'll tell you something, though, man. Getting that truck, it ain't gonna be easy. Damn, cult's got it, man. I'll be honest with you, it all started when I tried to join them. I mean, it just seemed like a good idea. I mean, they had all these guns, food, fine-ass females, and I mean, those are three things I'm really all about. I mean, it seemed like one big party over there. So I said, hey, Migos, where do I sign up? He said, sign up right here, friend. Then they started all their dang rules, man. No fornicating. Turns out that means fucking. No alcohol and no wilding out and partying, man. No thank you. So I got the fuck out of there, man. Unfortunately, though, I forgot my daddy's truck. He's been real butt sore since, so I gotta get that truck. You don't gotta worry about a thing, man. I got a 9-step plan to get this truck back. Step one, catch day buzz off party liquor. Got that one covered. Step two, pray for someone else to solve my problem. Done. Step three is... Shit, I forget the rest, but they'll come to me as soon as we go. Dang, you are a good listener, Boba Fett. My old man doesn't listen at all. I guess that's why I never feel hurt. Me and him, we ain't getting along that well lately. Ever since he started running for office, he's been coming down on me real hard about everything. About my public intoxication, how I handle my firearms, stuff like that. But when we get his truck back from them Peggy's, he's gonna be real impressed, dude. He's gonna love me so much, and then my mom's gonna have to try and love me more so she can compete with how much he loves me. And then he'll see how much she's loving me, and then he'll try and love me even more, and then birthdays and Christmases, they're gonna be off the chain. All right, man, this is the place. My granddaddy did in World War II with all them foreign prostitutes. It's gonna be fun, man. I'm about to wind y'all on their ass. I like to cut this kid. Play your cards right, I might lose something I've been cooking up. I love the feet. Actually all the way down yonder, probably more Peggy's waiting for us too. It's all about the zipline, man. We gonna zipline in there, sneak up on them like ninjas. Dude, you should hang out with my little cousin Sharky while you're in town. You met him yet, man? He is fucking good people. Yeah, his parents weren't around so much, so I basically raised him, man. He's kind of like my son in a way. I did a kick-ass job too, man. He rocks it hard. Real into shooting guns, explosions, and slamming beers, and clams. Oh, man, second coolest dude in Hope County, probably. You'd like him. Oh my goodness, man. I do not want to get ahead of myself, but I can tell already that we're gonna be best friends. Probably end up with tattoos of each other. Oh man, fate has brought us together, Migo. I feel that in my heart. Or is it the fate of the Monkey King that brought us together? Well, I guess it's the same thing. I mean, he controls all wonderful things in the world, so. Jacob's too happy about us blowing his guys away. Oh, mighty Monkey King, whose art in heaven. You have blessed me with the sticky green, the cheap beer, and the sweetest of bros. I party in your name and in your name only. If I could ask you but for one small favor, please, Monkey God, please come down from your heavenly vine and do something about these Peggies. They worship a lesser God than thee and are killing the beautiful, bountiful buzzes of which you have provided me with today. Amen.
Go, go, go!
whoop ass left. And pass me a beer if there's one.
And while you were gone, this whole Senate run is too much for me to handle on my own. I'm in need of a campaign manager, and you're just the kind of go-getter I need to get my ass in office. First task I got is to take Junior with you wherever you go, so I don't have to hear him praying to that goddamn Monkey King no more. Second task is, let me think on it a bit. I'll get back to you.
Hey, Buckaroo.
You managed to escape for a little bit. But whenever I want, I can have you back here with me. But you've got time to play your little games. I'll let you know when it's time to come home.
Soon enough. Did you think you were free? Well, your little buddy went to a whole lot of trouble for nothing.
That's okay.
He knows better now. I told you, you're not a hero. You are a tool. You knew your purpose. Beginning.
your sacrifice!
Ronnie, Parker, this is what he does, and we let him right in. You find that motherfucker. You find Jacob. And you kill him. Or next time I see you, so help me God, I'll kill you myself.
What?
About time you came out. I thought I'd have to come get you. I was worried you turned soft on me. But you're a soldier. Chance to prove himself. All he had to do was hand over his whitetails. Could have saved us all this trouble. Let's say you get out of this. What's next? You go back to running errands for a teenager and a housewife? The whitetails are nothing without Eli. You are nothing without Eli.
Thank you.
meat.
You're tougher than I thought. But killing me won't change a goddamn thing. You think I give a shit if I die? That's my purpose. I give my life for Joseph's, and I do it gladly. I understand my role. I am his sacrifice. Simple as that.
The wolves are all around you.
Don't you find it ironic that everyone you try to help winds up worse off?
Eli.
Pratt. Tragedy just follows you. If you really wanted to keep people safe, be a hero. You just off yourself. Safer for everyone that way.
My brother saw all this coming. I don't know if he talks to God. That doesn't matter. He was right. You humanity is once again in crisis. It doesn't matter what we build or achieve. We will always find a way to break it down. Babylon, Rome, empires rise, empires fall. America, we're no different. We think we're indestructible. World War II, War on Terror. We survived it, but it only brought us closer to the edge. And this is where we are, right here, on schedule, just waiting for someone to push us. And oh boy, if you pushed us. You did everything he said you would do. And you didn't even know it. You had no fucking clue.
Thank you is the right thing to say, but, well, Eli's death won't be in vain now. I'm sorry about what's happened, truly. You ain't the only one to blame, but now ain't the time to mourn or point fingers. That deputy Pratt of yours and a whole bunch of our whitetails are wasting away in Jacob's armory. Get moving. We're counting on you.
Deputy! You might want to pop in a nearby shop and check out.
Thank you.
able to undo that with Jacob's key.
Finish me off!
Good luck.
Thank you.
Each of us found the whitetail in our own ways. But what brought us here was loss. Families. Friends. Eli gave us back a little piece of that. He showed us the only thing we can rely on is each other. He was my friend. And I'm gonna miss him. It wasn't you, Eli knows that.
Eli thought if we could just hang on. Wait it out. Eden's Gate would just go away. But they won't.
Fuck no, they won't.
Cancer doesn't fade. It grows. It spreads. You have to cut it out.
Yeah.
These fucking Peggies believe the end of the world is coming.
Yeah.
It is for them. Eden's Gate ends today. We won't stop until every last one of those motherfuckers is hanging from these trees. Yeah.
Another seal has been opened. My family, my brothers, my sisters, they've been taken from me by a snake in the garden! I thought I knew God's plan. But I was wrong. I was blind. But now I see. You took my family from me so that I could have yours. We will welcome them with open arms. Just as we will welcome you. We will be waiting for you. Where it all began.